Why are you here?
I came because you needed me. I've been watching over you.
In heaven?
No, I'm afraid. I wasn't anywhere near there.
Take me to him.
Who?
Grant.
I can't do that.
Please. I'm ready.
It's not your time. I know how it feels to lose someone. The weight crushes in on you till you think you can't breathe. And you think that joy, beauty, and peace never existed, but they exist. And you'll feel them again. You just have to be patient and strong.
I can't.
Sure you can. You're my girl, aren't you? You know, someday soon, you'll be thinking of Grant. Something he said to you. Or maybe even just a look he gave you. And you'll brace yourself for that pain that always comes. That brutal sense of loss. And it won't be there. Instead, there'll just be a sweet sadness. And that's when you'll know, Macy. You'll know the healing has begun.
I don't want to forget.
Oh, you couldn't forget him. Any more than I could forget you. All those years, I thought of you every day. Wondering how you were. If I'd ever see you again. You hated me. I never wanted to leave you or your mother.
Then why did you?
I had no choice. I know you can't understand that. And there's no way I could explain it to you now. But just remember that I love you. I always have. And I will see to it that you get through this. I promise. I'll be back.
No, Daddy, wait. Dr. Madigan, do you know where I can find?
Who are you to lecture me? Talk about preaching to the converted. Did you ever once come to my church?
You know what, Daddy? I don't need to hear that speech again. I've heard it too many times as it is. You know, I thought that we could try to find a way to talk to each other, you know, after all this time. I figured, hey, I grew up. Maybe you did too.
For your information, there are some who think you will probably never grow up. Still the rebellious teenager. You can't put two sentences together without attacking me.
Daddy, this is not about me. This is about whether or not you're ready to face the truth so we can finally be honest with each other.
You want to face the truth? All right, here it is. The truth is you have been nothing but a source of humiliation to me since practically the day you learned to talk. You have tried throughout your life to spite me in every way your sordid little mind could come up with, including by abandoning the faith that is my life and becoming a Catholic.
An unpardonable sin if ever there was one. Give me
all the dream. Right, then let's leave religion out of it. How about when you were thrown out of college, delivered by the police to the door of the church, my church? And now look at you. Here you are in a public place, reeking of alcohol, practically tearing the clothes off of who knows what kind of man. I had hopes, faint though they were, that Andrew could lead you back onto the right path. But it is clear to me, even if it isn't to him, that you will never be anything but a whore.
Well, you want to throw stones, that's fine, Daddy. Let's throw stones. I'm a whore, okay? But it's a damn sight better than being a murderer like you.
You stop this right now!
I will not stop, and I don't care who hears me because it's the God's honest truth! You killed Mark!
Mark! Somebody's dead. Get on your feet. Please, Jim. You stay out of this, Dad.
Your father's right, Wyler.
Make a choice.
Hanson, do what he says.
Hanson! Now, we're moving outside. Put your guns down.
Been here, don't you?
Sir, I swear he never entered.
He came in through the window. Damn it!
Do you want us to seal off the roof?
No. I want him to know we found out. If he got in once, he may think he can do it again. I want you to put a spotter out there somewhere where he can watch the roof with a night scope. Now!
Yes, sir.
Take your tambourine and beat it, sweetheart.